Hello there, my name's Dane Lemaitre, and welcome to another review on the Hornby Thomas the Tank Engine range. Today we are reviewing two diesels, D261 and D7101. Both of these diesels were seen in the Railway series, but only D261, who's also known as Class 40 and the Diesel, he was the only one that made it into the television series. So we'll start with him first. The first problem I'm going to say is that, as you know, Hornby used tooling from other locomotives, and they've used a Class 37, whereas he is also known as Class 40, so it's quite disappointing that they use a Class 37, and the Class 40 has an extra pair of wheels. But nevertheless, all the detailing on the sides there, and I mean, without looking at the wheel arrangement, you could easily be fooled and realise that it's not. And that it looks more or less like his TV series model. One thing that always amazed me was how different he looked in the Railway series compared to the television series. I think his face is captured really well. It looks just like his face in the television series, and which also had a bit of resemblance to his Railway series face. He is, of course, painted a two-tone type green, and he looks very much like his television series model colour-wise. One thing with this model was that it came with black buffers. However, this has been carried on into the magazine as well, but I prefer the silver ones that he had in the television series, and so as you can probably see, I've painted the buffers silver. I did that in about March this year, the same time I did Stepney's, and so there's the back. Another issue that I do find is if you look carefully, I mean, you might not be able to see it as well as me, but you can see all the wiring through his cab windows, and you'd have thought maybe they'd have blacked them out or something, so that it wasn't so visible in that sense. The packaging on the model's really good. And also, looking underneath him, once again, like Murdoch and Spencer, it does not say the year that he was made. On the box it said 2006, so we can only assume it was around that time he was made. Another thing as well is that D261's buffers came to the ground in the television series, whereas they don't here, they fit. It's quite small. Let's say it's up there, it's not down there. And however, again, in the magazine it's issues, this has been carried over. The next engine I'll be looking at is D7101. Later on he became known as Bear because of the growling noises that he used to make, and he was painted green, the proper Hi-Met colours. So he was blue originally, as you can see in the photo on the right in the Railway series illustration. Obviously, illustration-wise, when he was painted blue, I can't say that we saw we can't say we've seen a great deal of him. I have the Ertl model here, and I think the Ertl model, I know it's smaller than that, but it's a lot more accurate to what he actually looks like than the Hornby model. If you have a look at the Hornby model, I mean, on the front it should. There's bits of blue, whereas it should actually, I think, like the Hornby model, it should just be yellow on the front, and I think, not the Hornby model, sorry, the Ertl model, it should all be yellow on the front. I think that's a lot better. And also, they've gone, for his face, they've used a yellow block to put his face on, and I think it should be painted on like how the, as you saw, the Ertl model was. And also, I think the fact that they've gone for a darker shade of yellow on the, face, it makes it look rather unusual. And I think as well the yellow that was used here was a bit too bright really, and I think maybe if a bit darker yellow than that was used, it could have been one of the best models. It is a good model though. It has a lot of detailing, and it has silver sprung buffers, so I didn't have to paint the buffers on that one luckily. And it looks like his British Rail blue livery, like I said, when he was first introduced. The roof on D7101 is the next issue. As you can see, on the Ertl model, it was grey with a black circle. And again, with the roof here, pretty much think all the parts are there. but they've gone blue again. They've put some blue horns on it, and the roof itself is like a is again that's a sort of blue, but it should be grey. And I think the Ertl model has captured him again a lot better than the Hornby model. Looking at these models again, I think they are very good and detailed models. However, score wise, I don't think they're perfect to give a 10 out of 10. Score wise, I've had to think quite long and hard, but I think I'd give D7101 a 9 out of 10. And I would also do, and I think again, 9 out of 10 for this one. So I think, yeah, both diesels a 9 out of 10. Like I said, not quite there to give the 10. But again, quite nice models. They both run really well indeed. I think with D7101, it's quite a shame that he's not in his green proper Hi-Met colours, which he received after being purchased by the Fat Controller in the book Enterprising Engines. Like I said, the Ertl model does this as well, and I think green would have been a lot better. Also, if you're like me and go to a number of model railway shows and run railway exhibitions, I recommend you don't take him, as I got loads of offers from people wanting to buy him off of me. They all like the Hi-Mex, and what they liked as well is that obviously all the real Hi-Mex only go up to D7100, whereas obviously this one's 01, so it's a bit of a pun on the Reverend W. Audrey's behalf. D7101 here was actually bought for me quite a few years ago as a birthday present. He was reintroduced in around 2012 as limited production. However, I bought one. It was quite brand new actually. Parents bought him for me from shop off the internet, and he was in the old style packaging, so not one of the reintroduced ones. D261 again, a model that they have a few of still. Was at Els Barton, Jay's Chemist. Again, quite a good shop and has quite a few Thomas models. I recommend you go there. Next time we'll be looking at two more engines. This time, Donald and Douglas, the Scottish twins. Until then, thank you very much for watching and goodbye.